have some scotch tape that I'm going to be putting underneath my eye, and I'll show you how to do that. Get a little bit off, probably like that much. And what you want to do is stick it on the back of your hand to get some of the adhesive off and peel it off. So it's that excess adhesive is kind of like not on the tape anymore. It won't be getting on your face or anything. What you want to do is stick it under your eye, start at the bottom of your lashes, and angle it up towards the end of your brow. Right there. My EcoTools smudge brush. It's a really small brush like this. This color blue right here from the 88 Coastal Scents matte palette, sorry. Dampen your brush. You can use a mixing medium or you can just use water. Oh my gosh, I almost forgot the most important thing. You need to use some eyeshadow primer. So I'm just going to apply some eyeshadow primer to both of my eyes. So just get the smudge brush and with that blue, just run it across the top of your lash line. And make a little point out here. Out. What I'm going to do next is apply some really pastel pink all over my lid. It's going to be this pink right up here, the lightest pink up there. It looks white in the camera. Dampened my brush. I'm going to take like a very tiny bit of purple. It's going to be that purple. Wait, which purple? This purple. That color. Line my crease. Just darken the crease up a little bit. To take the same blue that I took a little bit earlier, I'm going to apply it right underneath my eye. Right here. And connect it with the top wing. I'm going to take a really light pastel blue, which is going to be up here, that blue right there. It's going to look like that. It's really, really pastel. I'm going to be taking the same, well, I should probably use a different brush. I'm going to use a MAC 219 brush. I'm going to apply it to my inner tear ducts. Right here. It's going to kind of connect the pink. And I'm going to bring it over to the dark blue. Kind of bring that up a little bit. I'm going to line my upper lash line with some black and create a little bit of a smaller wing than I did with the blue. Start at the end and I'm going to wing out just a little bit and bring it in. You want to load some mascara on to bring it all together. To focus on your lips. I mean, I don't use pink lipstick a lot, so I have this really old lip liner, and it's from Hot Topic, so I don't really have any complaints about the quality of it though. And it looks like this. It's so small. I used to use it a lot on my eyes because I was kind of into that style. But I would tell you the brand, Hot Pink, I don't know. It's something with a skull and I don't remember the brand of it. But what you're going to do is align your lips perfectly, and let me zoom you in my lips and I'll show you how I do that. Alright, and now you're zoomed in on my lips. What you want to do is start with your Cupid's bow. And work outward, but really, really define your Cupid's bow. Now you want to go to your bottom lip and start on, I usually pick one side to start on. I'm going to fill your lips in. Right, now my lips are all pretty much filled in. The The pink I'm going to be using, if I can find it, is by, who's this by? Rimmel London, and this is in Pink Blush, and this is really similar to the Lady Gaga Viva Glam line in MAC. It's really similar to her color. It kind of has blue undertones. And I'm not gonna worry about a lip brush with pink because it doesn't really need to be that defined, but with red I would use the lip brush, but this is pink, so I'm just going to put this on my lips with out of the stick. Alright, now I'm gonna zoom you out. This is pretty much it for the entire look. I've got some blue and a little wing with, and it fades into black, and then I've got some pastel pink, and of course some pink, light pink lips. And so that's pretty much it for this look. And this is kind of, this isn't really an everyday-ish look. I would wear the pink lipstick out though, but the thing I would have a problem with wearing out is the blue winged eyeshadow. So if you want to tone that down a little bit, you don't have to take it out as far, or you could use like a darker, more navy blue. So you could wear that out. As for highlight, I forgot to mention any kind of highlight. I'm going to be using the Hard Candy Highlight Palette. I'm going to get a brush. I actually just recently started using a brush for my highlight. And I'm just using an angled brush. I'm going to dip it in the lightest highlight to apply it right above my brow, or right on my brow bone, I guess. And I'm also going to apply some highlight right outside of the blue. And that is all for the look. I'm going to turn this light off. Might be a little better for you. Well, it's not at all, but that's it for the look. I'm going to take some pictures now so you guys have you can tell a little better what the colors are really like, because this fluorescent light really drowns out the colors. And I'll also have some pictures and some information in my blog, so if you want to check that out, I'll have a link down to my blog in the information bar. So check that out, and I'll talk to you guys later. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, the Libra tutorial, and I'll see you soon. Bye.